السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
Allah sent the Prophet Muhammad, may Allah bless him and grant him peace, as a messenger to the whole universe. Allah says in the Quran, we send thee not but as a mercy for all creatures. And so Prophet Muhammad is the messenger of Allah to the Bedouins in the desert, just as he is the messenger of Allah to the present day scientist in his modern laboratory. He is the messenger of Allah to all peoples of all times. Before Prophet Muhammad, each messenger was sent exclusively to his own people. Allah said, to every people, a guide has been sent. But Prophet Muhammad's message is to all of mankind. And it is for this reason that Allah has given a supporting proof to the message of Prophet Muhammad, a proof which is different from the proofs given to the messengers before him. The proofs of the preceding messengers were only seen by their contemporaries and possibly by some generations immediately following them. Then Allah would send a new messenger supported with a new miracle in order to revive the faith of his people. Because Prophet Muhammad was destined to be the last of the prophets until the day of resurrection, Allah has given him an everlasting miracle as a supporting proof. If we ask a Jew or a Christian to show us the miracles of the Prophet Moses or Jesus, they both would submit that it is not within human power to redemonstrate any of those miracles now. Moses came cannot be recreated, and the Prophet Jesus cannot be invoked to raise people from the dead. For us today, these miracles are nothing more than historical reports. But if a Muslim is asked about the greatest miracle of the Prophet Muhammad, he can readily show his book, the Quran, which is a miracle in our hands. It is an open book for all mankind to examine its contents. Allah said in the Quran, say, what carries the most weight in testimony? Say, Allah is a witness between me and you. The Quran has been revealed to me that I may warn you with it and whomever it reaches. The miraculous nature of the Quran lies in the knowledge which it contains. Allah said, but Allah bears witness that which he has revealed to you, he has revealed from his own knowledge. Hence, our contemporary scientists and scholars, the professors in various universities who are leaders of human thought, have the opportunity to examine the knowledge which is found in the book of Allah. In this age, scientists have excelled in discovering the universe. But the Quran has already discussed the universe and human nature. So what was the result? We present Professor Keith L. Moore, one of the world's prominent scientists of anatomy and embryology. We ask Professor Moore to give us his scientific analysis of specific Quranic verses and prophetic traditions, a hadith pertaining to his field of specialization. Professor Keith Moore is the author of The Developing Human, which has been translated into 8 languages: Russian, Japanese, German, Chinese, Italian, and Portuguese. When we asked Professor Moore to give us his analysis of the Quranic verses and prophetic tradition, a hadith, he was amazed. He wondered how the Prophet Muhammad, 14 centuries ago, could describe the embryo and its development phase in such detail and accuracy, which scientists have come to know only in the last 30 years. Very quickly, however, Professor Moore's amazement grew into admiration for this revelation and guidance. He introduced these views to intellectual and scientific circles. He even gave a lecture on the compatibility of modern embryology with the Quran and Sunnah. Introducing Professor Moore, here is Dr. Abdullah Nassif, ex-director of the King Abdulaziz University.
Our guest today is Dr. Keith Moore, professor of anatomy and embryology at the University of Toronto, Canada. And before, at the University of Winnipeg in Western Canada for 11 years. Then, the head of the anatomy department for 6 years. He has headed many international associations, such as Canadian and American associations of anatomists and the Council of the Union of Biological Sciences. التي يندرج تحت التشريح والأجنة وعلم وظائف الأعضاء والكيمياء الحيوية والعلوم الحيوية الأخرى كما انتخب عضوا في الجمعية الطبية الملكية. Professor Moore was also elected to the membership of the Royal Medical Association of Canada, the International Academy of Cytology, the Union of the American Anatomists, and the Union of North and South American Anatomists. Professor Moore has published many books on clinical anatomy and embryology. 8 of them are used as reference works in medical schools and have been translated into 6 languages, namely Italian, German, Portuguese, Spanish, Greek, and Chinese.
It has been a great pleasure for me to help clarify statements in the Quran about human development. It is clear to me that these statements must have come to Muhammad from God or Allah, because almost all of this knowledge was not discovered until many centuries later. This proves to me that Muhammad must have been a messenger of God or Allah.
Consider what this well-known and respected scientist of embryology declared upon studying the Quranic verses related to his discipline and his conclusion that Muhammad, may Allah bless him and grant him peace, must have been a messenger from Allah.
This proves to me that Muhammad must have been a messenger of God or Allah.
In comparing the freshwater leech to the embryo at the alaqa stage, he found a great similarity between the two. Professor Moore concluded that the embryo during the alaqa stage acquires an appearance very similar to that of a leech. Professor Moore worked on this phenomena. He placed on picture of a leech together and side by side with a picture of an embryo and in an illustrative form. As we see, he presented the two pictures to scientists at several conferences, as we see in the picture. We can also see here the attachment of the embryo during the alaqa stage to the uterus, the womb of the mother. The word alaqa also means a clot of blood. It is significant to note, as Professor Moore stated, that during the alaqa stage, the embryo blood resembles the formation of blood in closed vessels until the metabolic cycle is completed between the embryo and the placenta. During the alaqa stage, the blood is then caught within closed vessels, and that is why the embryo acquires the appearance of a blood clot. Hence, in the alaqa stage, the embryo acquires its human features. So how could Muhammad have possibly known that by himself? Professor Moore also studied the mudra, or chewed-like substance. He took a piece of raw clay and chewed it in his mouth, as you can see in picture B. He took a picture of the embryo at the mudra stage, as we can see in picture A. In comparing the two, Professor Moore concluded that the embryo at the Mudra stage acquires the exact appearance of a chewed-like substance. Several Canadian periodicals published many of Professor Moore's statements. In addition, he presented 3 television programs in which he highlighted the compatibility of modern science with what has been contained in the Quran 1400 years ago. Consequently, Professor Moore was asked a question. Does this mean that you believe that the Quran is the word of Allah? To which he replied, I find no difficulty in accepting this. He was asked, how can you believe in Muhammad while you believe in Jesus Christ? His reply was, I believe they both come from the same school. And thus, modern scientists all over the world today can come to know that the Quran has been revealed from Allah's knowledge. As Allah has told us, Allah bears witness that which He has revealed to you, He has revealed from His own knowledge. It also follows that Prophet Muhammad, may Allah bless him and grant him peace, is the messenger of Allah.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. ويرى الذين أوتوا العلم الذي أنزل إليك من ربك هو الحق ويهدي إلى صراط العزيز الحميد. صدق الله العظيم.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Praise be to the Lord of the universe, and may Allah bless and grant peace to the Prophet Muhammad and his family and his companions. This book, The Developing Human, written by Professor Keith Moore, has been translated into 8 languages. It is considered a scientific reference work and was chosen by a special committee in the United States as the best book authored by one person. We met with the author of this book and presented to him many Quranic verses and prophetic hadith which deal with his specialization in embryology. Professor Moore was convinced by our evidence, so we asked him, you mentioned in your book that in the Middle Ages there was no advancement in the science of embryology and that only very little was known at that time. At the same time, the Quran was being revealed to the Prophet Muhammad and he was guiding people according to what Allah revealed to him. There is found in the Quran very detailed description of the creation of man and of the different stages of human development. You are a world-renowned scientist. So, why do you not uphold justice and mention these truths in your book? He replied, you have the evidence and not I. So why do you not present it to us? He provided him with the facts. He proved to be a great scholar. In the 3rd edition of his book, he did make some additions. This edition enjoys worldwide distribution and is read by many of the world's foremost scientists who speak English, Russian, Chinese, Japanese, German, Italian, Portuguese, and Yugoslavian. They read the editions of Professor Moore in his book about the Middle Ages, that growth of science was slow during the medieval period and few high points of embryological investigation undertaking during this age are known to us. It is cited in the Quran, the holy book of the Muslim, that human beings are produced from a mixture of secretions from the male and the female. Several references are made to the creation of a human being from a sperm drop, and it is also suggested that the resulting organism settles in the woman like a seed 6 days after its beginning. The human blastocyst begins to implant about 6 days after fertilization. The Quran also states that the sperm drop develops into a clot of congealed blood. Reference is also made to the leech-like appearance of the embryo. The embryo shown in figure 5-3a is not unlike a leech or bloodsucker in appearance. The embryo is also said to resemble a chewed piece of substance. Developing embryo was considered to become human at 40 to 42 days and to no longer resemble an animal embryo at this stage. The human embryo begins to acquire human characteristics at this stage, as shown in figure 5-14c. The Quran also states that the embryo develops within three veils of darkness. This probably refers to 1. The maternal anterior abdominal wall, 2. The uterine wall, and 3. The amniochorionic membranes. Space does not permit discussion of several other interesting references to human prenatal development that appear in the Quran. This is what Dr. Moore has written in his book, and which is now being distributed throughout the world. Scientific knowledge has made it incumbent upon Professor Moore to mention this in his book. He has concluded that the modern classification of embryonic development stages, which is adopted throughout the world, is not easy or comprehensible. It does not contribute to the understanding of the embryonic stages development, because those stages are identified on a numerical basis. That is, stage 1, stage 2, 3, 4, 5. The divisions that have been revealed in the Quran do not depend on a numerical system. Rather, they are based on the distinct forms. The Quran identifies the stages as follows: nutfa, drop, alaqa, a leech, mudgha, a chewed-like structure, idham, bones, kasal idham bil-lahm, clothing the bones with flesh, and al-nash'a, the formation of a distinct fetus. Professor Moore has recognized that these Quranic divisions are actually based on the different phases of prenatal development. He has noted that these divisions provide scientific descriptions which are comprehensible and practical. In one of the conferences he attended, Professor Moore stated,
"The embryo develops in the mother's womb or uterus, protected by 3 veils or layers, as shown in this next slide. A represents the anterior abdominal wall. B, the uterine wall. And C, the amniochorionic membrane. Because the staging of human embryos is complex, owing to the continuous process of change during development, it is proposed that a new system of classification could be developed using the terms mentioned in the Quran and Sunnah. The proposed system is simple, comprehensive, and conforms with present embryological knowledge.
Intensive studies of the Quran and Hadith in the last 4 years have revealed a system for classifying human embryos that is amazing, since it was recorded in the 7th century A.D. Although Aristotle, the founder of the science of embryology, realized that chick embryos developed in stages from his studies of hen's eggs in the 4th century B.C., he did not give any details about these stages. As far as it is known from the history of embryology, little was known about the staging and classification of human embryos until the 20th century. For this reason, the descriptions of the human embryo in the Quran cannot be based on scientific knowledge in the 7th century. The only reasonable conclusion is that these descriptions were revealed to Muhammad from God. He could not have known such details because he was an illiterate man with absolutely no scientific training.
We told Dr. Moore, what you have said is true, but it is far less than the truth, and evidence we have presented to you from the Quran and the Sunnah, and which are related to the science of embryology. So why not do justice and completely bring to light all the Quranic verses and ahadith which deal with your field of specialization? He said that he has inserted the appropriate references at the appropriate places in a specialized scientific book. However, he would invite us to make some Islamic additions citing all the relevant Quranic verses and the prophetic ahadith and highlighting the various miraculous aspects to be incorporated at appropriate places in the book. This was done. And consequently, Professor Moore wrote an introduction to these Islamic editions, and the result was this book, which Dr. Moore had suggested, including the Islamic editions as you see here before you. On each page, which includes facts about the science of embryology, we have cited the Quranic verses and prophetic ahadith which prove the inimitability of the Quran and Sunnah. What we are witnessing today is Islam moving to new grounds within the fair and unbiased human minds.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. وَيَرَى الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمَ الَّذِي أُنْزِلَ إِلَيْكَ مِنْ رَبِّكَ هُوَ الْحَقِّ وَيَهْدِي إِلَى صِرَاطِ الْعَزِيزِ الْحَمِيدِ. صدق الله العظيم.
I think this is the time to say La ilaha illallah. There is no God to worship except Allah. Muhammad Dun Rasulullah. Muhammad is the Savior of Allah.
Creed Shahada and declaring that he is becoming a Muslim. This occurred during the 8th Saudi Medical Conference, which was convened in Riyadh. He is Professor Tagatasson, formerly head of the Department of Anatomy and Embryology at the University of Chiang Mai in Thailand, and he is now the Dean of the College of Medicine at that university. Our acquaintance started when we presented to him some Quranic verses and prophetic ahadith which deal with his specialization in the field of anatomy. He commented that they also had in their Buddhist books very accurate descriptions of embryonic development stages. We told him that we were very anxious and interested to see those descriptions and learn about these books. He promised to give further details. And when he came back to King Abdul Aziz University to examine students of medicine, as outside examiner, we reminded him of the statement he made 1 year before. But he apologized and said that he, in fact, had made that statement without ascertaining the matter. However, when he checked the Buddhist books, he found that they contained nothing of relevance to the subject. Upon this, we presented to him a lecture written by Professor Keith Moore about the compatibility of modern embryology with what is contained in the Quran and the Sunnah, and we asked him if he knew of Professor Keith Moore. He replied that he knew him, of course, adding that Professor Moore was one of the most world-renowned scientists in that field. After studying this article, he was astonished. We asked him a question about the modern discoveries in dermatology.
Yes, if the burn is deep and this destroy the receptor, if we will know the perception for sensation. You will be interested to know that in this book, the holy book, the Quran, there was a reference 1400 years ago which refers to the moment of punishment of the unbelievers by the fire of hell, and it states that when the skin is destroyed, Allah makes another skin for them so that they perceive the punishment by fire, indicating knowledge about the deep about the nerve endings in the skin. And the verse is إن الذين كفروا بآياتنا سوف نصليهم نارا كلما نضجت جلودهم بدلناهم جلودا غيرها ليذوقوا العذاب إن الله كان عزيزا حكيما. The translation of the meaning of this verse: those who reject our signs, we shall soon cast into the fire. As often as their skins are roasted through, we shall change them for fresh skin that they may taste the energy. For God is exalted in power and wise. So, do you agree that this is a reference to the importance of the nerve endings in the skin in sensation 1400 years ago?
Yeah, okay, do I?
ตลอดว่าที่เมื่อคนถูกทำโทษแล้วแล้วเอาไฟเผาแล้วเนี่ยความรู้สึกของคนคนนั้นจะหายไปที่ได้แต่ให้มีผิวหนังเกิดขึ้นใหม่ทำให้คนนั้นรู้สึกว่าไอ้ที่เราทำผิดเนี่ยมันเจ็บปวดแค่ไหน Yes, I agree with the knowledge about the sensation has known long before, because it said that if something do something wrong and then is what punished by burning his skin, and then the Allah put the fresh skin cover him to make him know the test or the painful again. That means that they know 100 years ago that the receptor of pain sensation might be in the skin. So they must put a new skin on.
The skin is the center of sensitivity to burns. Thus, if the skin is completely burned by fire, it loses